एवरीवन, आई एम मिसेस स्नेहल कपिल भौसा फ्रॉम आरसी पटेल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च शिरपुर. एज अ पार्ट ऑफ इंटरनेशनल FTP ऑन एनवायरमेंट एंड सस्टेनेबिलिटी, आई हैव टेकन अ लेक्चर ऑन रिसाइकलिंग ऑफ सॉल्वेंट्स, कार्बन फुटप्रिंटिंग एंड एनवायरमेंटल सस्टेनेबिलिटी. In week 1, I have discussed about pharmacy, environment and sustainability. In that video, I have stated some strategies for environment sustainability in pharmacy. In week 2, I have discussed about solvent in laboratories as air pollutant and how to maintain the environment sustainability by reducing the solvent emission. Today's lecture learning outcomes are: laboratory solvent causes the hazardous air pollutants, which is harmful to environment. Recycling of laboratory solvents and carbon footprinting. How to maintain the environment sustainability in relation to laboratory solvents. Process such as concentration and evaporation, recycle of solvent generate a tons of solvent vapors annually that are released into atmosphere. In the analytical chemistry laboratories, growing concern about the use and emission of volatile organic compounds and hazardous air pollutants show the environmental impact of solvents. The main goal of study has been to estimate the carbon footprinting of the recycled solvents. There is a process: waste solvent and raw material, recycling, plant storage and initial treatment, distillation, packing and then for the use. During this process, there is a utilization of electricity, heat or steam water. So that is a waste management as a solvent is recycled. Carbon emission or footprinting. What is meant by carbon footprint? The carbon footprint is the amount of greenhouse gas, primarily the carbon dioxide, released into the atmosphere by particular human activity. It is usually measured as a ton of CO2 emitted per year. The number that can be supplemented by tons of CO2 equivalent gases, including methane, nitrous oxide and other greenhouse gases. Here I have taken examples of some solvent along with their carbon footprinting, which is calculated for the per 1000 kg of the recycled solvent. Here we can find that mixed solvent 156, then acetone 421 and so on. Here the comparison of carbon footprint of recycled and virgin solvent, that means the original solvent and the recycled one, that are compared, and the results indicated recycling of these solvents lead to significant saving of greenhouse gas emission ranging from 46% to 92% compared to the virgin solvents. Sustainability computation. Environment sustainability by reducing the solvent emission. There are several ways to lessen harmful solvent emission. Some methods have been developed to reduce the amount of harmful substances used throughout the course of reaction, either by performing the reaction under milder condition, for example in water, or without any liquid solvent at all. This idea is to be eliminate emission by completely eliminating the source of pollution. Another way to address laboratory solvent emission is to reduce the sample starting volumes. This often requires the change in instrumentation and to lesser the degree a change in method. However, the new reaction do not need to be developed. And the third option is for reducing the emission is to treat the solvent vapor with the method such as adsorption, thermal destruction or condensation before the vapor can release into the atmosphere. In this method, up until the evaporation step, the procedure remains same for the any process, which eliminate the need to validate the new method. There is no need to validate new method. The procedure remains same. Only the instead of evaporation or recovering the solvent, the adsorption or thermal destruction method can be used. The adsorbent work by passing the vapor laden gas across the adsorbent, for example activated carbon or zeolite. So that is all about the solvent recycling, carbon footprinting and environmental sustainability. Thank you. Thank you very much.